So you finally got your hands on Photoshop, but you're feeling a little bit overwhelmed. Well, stop stressing because switching over from Canva is not as scary as it seems. So sit back because in this video, I'll show you how to get up and running with Photoshop in no time. First, let's start a new design project. Come over to your file and click on New. You will then be presented with a pop-up with a whole bunch of options, but before you freak out, let's go over the basics. At the top, you can download some of the standard sizes. If you scroll down, you can download some pre-made templates just like Canva. At the top, you can add a project title. Under that is where you would input your custom size for this project. Here you can change the orientation from vertical to horizontal. And right under that, you have the resolution for your project. I'm going to make my size 720 by 300 pixels, and I'm going to set the resolution to 72 dpi, and we'll change the color mode to RGB. Now, when it comes to resolution, the higher the number, the better. So if you're working on a project, 300 dpi is standard. If you're working for web, then 72 dpi would be a good place to start, but you can always go up and down in resolution depending on your project. As for the other options you see, you really don't have to worry about them. Once we have this all set up and ready to go, just click create. Now that your artboard has been created, you're now ready to start designing. But before you start clicking on random stuff, let me give you the overview. To your left-hand side, you have the toolbar. Now, I could spend another whole video describing each of these tools in more detail, but Adobe has already taken care of that for me. To learn more about each tool, all you have to do is hover over the icon and a little pop-up will show up. To the top, you'll have some additional tools that will change based on the tool you select to the left-hand side. And to the right, you have your color selector, properties, and your layer panel. And it's not too bad so far, right? Now let's add a background color. Come over here to the rectangle tool, click it, and create a rectangle. Now let's add a simple red gradient. Double-click the rectangle in your layer panel and click on Gradient Overlay. Now let's choose the colors for our gradient. I want to make my gradient a light to dark red, but feel free to mess around with different colors. To change the colors of your gradient, simply click on the gradient box. Now let's change the colors. Just double-click on the little color box and choose your color. You can drag the color picker around or add a custom hex code. Now repeat the same process for the other color box. Now we can change the angle of our gradient here and adjust the scale and even play around with different blending modes. Once you have something you like, just click on OK. Now what I want to do is add a little bit of depth to this background. To create depth for this project, I'm going to upload an image I found online with a little bit of a light ray. To upload an image into your project, go to File and select Place Embed. Then select the image you would like to place. Now I'll resize the image. To do this, simply hit Command T on your keyboard to adjust the box. Then click and drag till you're happy. Now I want to change the blending mode of this image to make it blend more into the red background. To do that, go to your blending mode dropdown and scrub through the different options to find one that works for your projects. For this example, I'll choose linear light and lower the opacity by coming over here and lowering it to about 20%. That looks great. Now let's add the Pocky Box. I'm going to go to the file, place embed, and now I'll adjust to fix the space better. Now I want to add a drop shadow to make it pop. To do that, double click the layer dropdown and select shadows. From here, we can change the dropdown shadow color, adjust the angle, adjust the distance, spread, and size. Once that looks good, you can now add your copy, but before we do that, let's organize our layers. Now, if you take anything away from this video, it's that organization in Photoshop is key. Let me show you how to do that. Come down over here to your group folder icon and select that. You will now see an empty folder in your layer panel. Let's rename it to the corresponding layer. So for me, I want to put just the box in, so I'll name the folder Product Box and repeat the same for the background images. Now we can add our copy. To do that, come to your toolbar and select Type Tool. You can even hit the T on your keyboard as a shortcut. Now click anywhere on your artboard and start typing. To change the font, the size, color, and other font settings, come to your top section right here. I'll pick Scholar Sans for this project. I'll then repeat the process for the rest of the copy. Now that I have all the copy laid out, I want this main section of the copy to pop a little. To do that, we'll add some slight drop shadow to the text. To do that, just double click the layer, get the layer panel up, and then click the drop shadow and adjust the settings like we have previously. Now let's add a CTA button. To do that, come to your rectangle tool, then click and drag anywhere on the canvas. Now let's round out the corners. With the rectangle layer selected, simply hover over the rectangle until you see the four little points on all four corners. Then click and drag on one of the corners. Now double click the layer to adjust the color of the button. Then all you need to do is add your copy. Come to your text tool or hit Command T on your keyboard and adjust the font settings. Last but not least, let's add some Pocky Sticks falling. First, we need to upload the assets. Now I'll adjust the size and reposition the sticks by hitting Command T on my keyboard. That looks great. Now let's duplicate that two more times. To do that, come to your stick layer and right click that layer and hit Duplicate Layer. Or you can always hit Command C as a shortcut. And all that's left to do is to reposition the sticks to something that looks good to you. You see, Photoshop might seem like an overwhelming program, but when you really look at what it has to offer, it does everything Canva does with more control and precision.